45-year-old Michael Connell, an experienced pilot, crashed into a vacant house. Well, tonight, more about Connell and his ties to a possible White House scandal. 19 Action News reporter Blake Chenault with more at 11.
This is where Michael Connell worked, and it was from this building that he provided services to President Bush. An investigation is ongoing to find out exactly what kind of services Connell from this building provided to the president.
The fatal plane crash of Michael Connell was certainly untimely. The 45-year-old local man was accused of rigging the 2004 election for President Bush, a claim that Connell denied under oath. But under closer examination, civil attorney Clifford Arnbeck wanted Connell placed under federal protection. Arnbeck was worried that if Connell told all that he knew about President Bush and the 2004 campaign, Connell's life would be in jeopardy. Arnbeck said he received confidential information that Republican operative Karl Rove threatened Connell and his wife if Connell told all that he knew.
So who exactly is Michael Connell? Well, he worked here as a Republican computer specialist and consultant. Basically, he's accused of taking votes in 2004 from then-candidate John Kerry and diverting them to President Bush throughout the state of Ohio. But last month, under oath in a federal court, Connell denied having any knowledge of manipulating votes.
Records show the Bush campaign paid Connell's business some $800,000 in 2004, but it's unclear for what. Connell, though, was apparently told by a close friend not to fly his plane because the plane might be sabotaged. And twice in the last 2 months, Connell, who was an experienced pilot, canceled two flights because of suspicious problems with his plane. And now, last night, he had another problem with his plane, but this one took his life.
It is too early to tell if the federal investigation into the cause of Connell's death has any kind of tie to the work he provided from this office to the president. In Richfield, Blake Chenault, 19 Action News.
Mike Connell has been named as Karl Rove's computer guru since 2000. The lawyers in the case refer to Connell as a high IQ Forrest Gump because he's been on the scene of every dubious election we've had over the last 8 years, starting with Florida 2000. Now, he has been named by a man named Stephen Spoonamore, S-P-O-O-N-A-M-O-R-E, who's a very unusual and particularly unimpeachable kind of whistleblower. He's a conservative Republican. He's a former McCain supporter, but above all, he is a renowned and highly successful expert at the detection of computer fraud. He works for big banks, he works for foreign governments, the Secret Service. His job is to figure out how computers are used to steal money or information or votes. Well, he's named a lot of people in the Bush-Cheney election subversion conspiracy. He's worked with them. He knows them personally. And months ago, he named Mike Connell and his company GovTech Solutions as having played a crucial role in the electronic subversion of the vote in Ohio in 2004. And Spoonamore has actually described the computer architecture that was used to do this. Now, on the strength of this testimony, the lawyers in the case had the judge issue a subpoena to Mike Connell last week. Connell defied the subpoena. He was in contempt. Late last week, the lawyers filed a motion to compel compliance, and to everyone's surprise and delight, the judge ordered Connell to appear today and to be deposed for 2 hours about his role in this long-standing electronic plot, basically, to flip votes towards the Republicans. Some of this deposition will be sealed, and I have to tell you the part that will be sealed. Apparently, Rove has threatened Connell. He told him that if Connell did not take the fall for this whole thing, the Department of Justice would start investigating Connell's wife, Heather, for improper lobbying practices. Now, that part of the deposition we're not going to know the answers to, But what's astonishing to me...
Who does she lobby for?
Various politicians and so on. Whether she's guilty or innocent is beside the point. Because as we know, the Department of Justice is a cudgel in the collective hands of the Bush administration. This would be more selective prosecution. But what's really astonishing here is that Karl Rove could make that threat with such impunity. This shut Connell up. And he was, you know, earlier inclined to talk about what was going on. Then he got himself three very expensive Republican attorneys who promised that they would make sure he could not be deposed before Election Day. Well, hallelujah, he's being deposed before Election Day. And the reason why...
Today.
The reason why this is so important and the strategy behind the early part of this case all along has been that if we can shine a spotlight on the perpetrators of this kind of fraud before Election Day, make them nervous, make them pull in their horns, distract them, is a good chance that they might not try to do what they're clearly ready to do. Because let me just add, Connell is on the McCain payroll. He's working for McCain right now, and he specializes in a particular kind of computer architecture whose only purpose, Spoonamore says, is to steal votes.
I want to go back to two issues. One, how do you know Karl Rove made these threats? That's a very strong allegation.
Well, it is a very strong allegation. It comes from the lawyers. The lawyers were evidently told by Connell or someone close to him. But this stuff has been on the website of Velvet Revolution. Raw Story has reported it. The media, however, has remained over-focused, of course, on Acorn, which is a nothing story. But let me make clear that the brouhaha over Acorn, right, this orchestrated propaganda drive about Acorn, has many distracting purposes, and one of them, I promise you, is to distract us from this case. This case is an Ohio RICO case. Well, lately, the Republicans filed an Ohio RICO case against Acorn, and I think the
RICO
purpose...
RICO meaning racketeering.
It's a racketeering case. Ohio has the strongest racketeering statute in the country. This is one of the reasons why the lawyers decided to go there and do this.
What do you mean he specializes in the computer architecture, the internet architecture that can steal elections?
Well, it's a system. If people go to the website for Velvet Revolution, particularly www.rovecybergate.com, they'll find the documents that Spoonamore has filed describing the setup that's known as Man in the Middle. This happened in Ohio in 2004. It involves shunting the data that comes from the website for the Secretary of State, I mean the election returns, taking those election returns as they come to the website in real time and shunting them to a computer somewhere else. What happened in 2004 was the election returns from Ken Blackwell's website were shunted to a computer in a basement in Chattanooga, Tennessee, under the control of a very partisan private company to which Connell was connected. The data was shunted to this strange computer in Chattanooga and then directed back to the Secretary of State's website. As Spoonamore has said, the only purpose of doing this, man in the middle thing, is to commit crime.
Thank you.